So I'm not able to speak very great Tamil, so I speak in English. So all of you are never said. So you are not able to, so I don't want to go into this. Are you able to hear me?
Yes, sir.
Clear? So this is an interactive session. Can you hear me? Clear? Can you hear the last speaker? Hello? No? Can you hear me?
Yes.
See, the introduction part is over. I want all of you to have pen and paper so that we can see where all we are making wrong things. So this is already a series. So these are the some of my mentors, and I have gone through their YouTube lectures, classes, and then I have gone certain programs and all that. The last 10 years, I am very passionate to learn. See, what is most important is learning, unlearning and relearn. Very important. Many of times, we are stuck with our own learning and we don't relearn. It's very important. This today we are going to do a lot of relearning. And this is my wife and me way back in 2013-14. This transformation has taken 4 months. 4 months. Last 10 years, I've been able to maintain my same height and height is same weight and all that. There is no issues. And I do give lectures in a lot of corporates also. Everything is free of cost. And I do conduct the Zoom meetings free of cost. And there are, in fact, recently I'm doing a program for Kuwait, Qatar Association. I'm giving lectures. Friends, if you just listen one of my video from my YouTube channel, you are going to get all the knowledge. Whatever I spend time, you are going to get in half an hour time. Let's see how this is going to go about. So this is where Ashok Leyland and one of the training program. Recently, I was at Hyderabad. There is a program. Are you able to hear me? All clear? All right. So there is a program of health camp. 15 days camp was there. They were charging 6,000 rupees for poor people, and I was there for a week to guide them. And let me tell you, in about 30 days, so now the program is almost over. In about 30 days, all the 21 participants have lost 2 to 2.5 kg weight. Not only that, they find more energetic and more comfortable with their body. Most important is that. Weight loss, I generally don't talk weight loss. It's basically we are becoming healthy, feeling ease and comfortness. So these are the few people who have benefited. I must thank Dr. Bala sir and now Mr. Sethil. He has done a wonderful job in a span of 1 month. He has shown such an improvement, it is really, I am not able to understand that. I just have spent time with him. How he has improved his health substantially. Maybe he wants to come and talk to you later. And this we have seen. Friends, I have a question. In fact, my son stays in US. So every year, last 10 years, 12 years, I am going every day, every time with my wife in a flight. But this time I have decided to go by boat. And I am going to go on a motor boat myself, alone. So, can I have some suggestions? What all the precautions I should take so that I reach my destination without any havoc? All of you got my question? Let me tell you, the distance is 18,000 kilometers. From Chennai to San Francisco, 18,000 kilometers. So, the motor boat generally goes about 20 kilometers per hour. So, let's say in a day, 10 hours I go, 200 kilometers. So it may take about 3 months for me to go. So can you suggest me, what should I do? I'm an automobile engineer, I know how to go about it. But nevertheless, I just want to have some suggestions from you. Can anybody suggest? So last time in one of my conference, they said, no sir, don't go alone, it is dangerous. Another person said, go with somebody. So in this, I said, no, I want to try this time. So of course, it's some crazy stuff, but I want to do that. There is a reason why I am asking this question. Anybody can tell me what sort of small precautions? Have you all of you understood the question? Hello? No issue, just some suggestions. Okay, let me tell you, what should I do? Primarily, I go and see a boat. Check the boat. Is the boat in good condition for me to take 100 days? So that I don't get any mishap, so I check the boat thoroughly, correct? All of you okay? I can't take a lousy boat, I can't take a bad boat or a damaged boat or a boat with some defect, isn't it? All of you agree?
I need to take a good book, correct? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
I want responses.
Yes.
So the important thing is the board. So first thing is I am going to check the board. How is the condition of the board? Is the motor working? Are the parameters are working or not? I check. Is it right? So next what I do, I see the manual of that board manufacturer. The board manufacturer tells me what to do, what not to do. Very important. I just can't do that. There's the operator manual and maintenance manual. If you're buying a new car, they provide a manual. If you buy a diesel car, the manufacturers tell you to put only diesel, just can't put any other stuff. So similarly, I understand about the board. And then I also want to know what is that I should not do so that that board will get damaged on my way. I'm traveling 100 days, if I do some silly stuff, the board get damaged, I'm going to get sunk. So don't, what is that I should not do? Next is, how do I maintain and manage all the 100 days? Just hypothetical question. Why I am asking this question, friends? Remember, we all come with this body, human body, right? So until we are until the last breath, the body is with you. We don't know whether your parents are with you, your spouse is with you, your children are with you, isn't it? What is with you is your body. Don't you take importance of your body? Don't you see what is the condition of the body so that you navigate through your life? We don't know whether we are going to live 1 year, 10 years, 20 years, we don't know. But as long as we live, don't we think we should have a boat which is fit enough to go at high speed? Yes, let's look at that. Friends, who is your life partner? If I ask anybody, who is your life partner? Many times you say, my father, my mother, my spouse, my son and all that. Friends, your life partner is your body. Remember that. So what is that we need to do the body? Are you keeping it all right? Just go through, I don't want to get into this, it's a write-up available on your body, so we look at it. Now, there are three steps in this approach, that means what? What are we are trying to understand from this? We are just checking as of today, whatever has happened, we don't know. Your body today, either you are overweight, you are taking some medicine or XYZ, is the result of your habit so far. So now you have come here, I just want to check your boat, what is the condition? So let's look at it. I put it in a little metaphor. If your boat has one hole or 10 holes, it's going to put you into trouble. So we need to see how many holes, how many cracks, how many defects we have in our boat. So I have created a 10 parameter health score. So what is that generally, if anybody you see physically, how do you say is healthy or unhealthy? Primarily you see a guy is overweight, he looks a little fat, or he has a belly fat. That's all. These are only two things we can say about anybody. Internally, we don't know. Does he have blood pressure? We don't know. Does he have a sugar? We don't know. Does he have a thyroid? We don't know. Does he have a lipid problem? We don't know. Unless we do that blood test. So I have created a 10 parameter health score. So let's look at that. Before that, I want to show you something very important. Friends, this is a write-up from Times of India, 10th June. ICMR, Indian Council of Medical Research. What they have done, so, am I audible and is it clear what I am speaking? If there is any not clear, please ask. Okay. So ICMR had made a survey. What they have done, they went to different cities like Goa, Pondicherry, similar places. They have done certain tests and they have given a health program, health card of the Indians. What they say, look at it here. They say about 28.6% Indians are obese. Let me go to the next slide before clearer. See, how many people are overweight? 40 crore people of India. Of course, they have not done all the tests for everybody. They have done few samples and the statistics people are there. They probably explained it saying that 40 crore people. 56 crore people are belly fat. That means gents probably, you know, third month, fourth month, something like that. Many times I see ladies less with their belly, but gents more in the part. Most of them looks to be they are probably 7th month, 8th month, that level. Very unfortunate. What is the next? Blood pressure. 50 crores people. Friends, let me tell you, in this group, we have few people who are obese, who have belly fat, who have blood pressure. We are under medication. Pre-diabetes and diabetes. See, all of us know, but somehow we take it very easily. Diabetes, pre-diabetes. Generally, I hear the statements from people, yes sir, diabetic, I'm taking very less medicine. I'm on water, under control. Friends, once you put your foot in the
what I should say, kitchen, what is that called, dirt, your food is dirty. So if you are diabetic, you are taking even one medicine, which is not good. Don't you think all of us should live a life without medicine? Tell me. Is it our goal? Hello? Do you want to live with medicine or without medicine? How many of you want to live without medicine? Raise hands. Alright, I'm glad. So, see, medicine is something like it, you know, you are putting fire every day and you are putting water on it. Next day again there is some fire. So every day you are taking medicine. See, many times we get a fever, we take medicine 2 days, then you don't have to take lifelong, isn't it? But we are taking lifelong medicine. One, two. Friends, as I said to you, I was taking 11 medicine. Morning 5, evening 6. But at that point of time, I have no idea. I thought, oh, it's all right. What is all right? I just pop 5 pills in the morning and 5-6 pills in the night. I used to do like that. I was not aware that this medicine in the long run can cause havoc to the body. Let's look at it. Lipid profile, triglycerides, lipid profile, cholesterol is very high. How many people? Look at it. 115 crore people. Don't you think it is very alarming? If I'm a health minister, probably I will have a sleepless nights because the situation is not at all good. Friends, all of you must have seen during Dashara in Gujarat, there is a Garba dance. All of you are aware of Garba dance? You know what happened? Have you seen the news? News says, during that Garba 10 days, there are about 500 phone calls for ambulances. That means people playing simple Garba, they have collapsed, they have fallen, fainted and all that. So they were taken by the ambulance to the hospital or some sort of first aid. And also, in the same news I heard, 10 people have died in 24 hours time doing playing Garba. Can you believe it? It is something like in Telugu, there is a kahavat. If you sneeze, the nose will fall off. So you have to be very careful. Like that we have become. See now, what happened, friend? See, they have done only these tests. See, look at the medical model. See, an elephant is being seen by people, blind people. What happens? Somebody will describe one way, another fellow will describe some other way. Somebody holds the legs of the elephant and say it is like a pillar. So that's how the medical fraternity has happened. Now, what are the more important things required is something called fasting insulin. We will go into the thyroid, vitamin levels. So we have this, look at these 10 pyramids I have put it here. We will now map each of you, your health are these 10 parameters, provided you have the blood marker. We'll go to the next thing. Now I have done my own survey 2019-20-21. Anybody comes to Chennai to my house, I don't go with them to the temple, I take them to the laboratory. I used to get their blood test. Look at the how. Out of 62 people, 47 are obese. Out of 62, 21 people are pre-diabetes, 20 people are diabetes. More alarming is something called insulin resistance. Just now, Balasar was explaining to you. What is the problem of insulin resistance? Mainstream medicines is not talking about it. These tests are not done. So what happens? Many times you may have seen, somebody is overweight, and there's no other health problem, the blood test is done. The blood reports are, everything shows normal. Doctor says that everything is fine, but the guy is already 25 kg overweight. Now how come we are unable to capture the health problem in the lab reports? Can anybody tell me? Somebody is overweight, having a belly fat, but all his reports are normal. Is it possible? Something like it, you know, you say my son, 10th class son, he goes to school regularly, he studies well, he has a tuition, is a good corporate school, he goes by bus, in the house also we don't see TV, we make him study, but he gets 20 marks. Is it acceptable? That means there's something wrong, isn't it? That means the blood reports what are showing normal, but the person is not normal. Person is carrying almost 20 kg overweight. So this is the problem, friends. We will understand this. As I said to you, I was in Hyderabad, 21 people were there. Look at the pathetic situation. Out of 21, 11 people are having, 52% people are under medication. So the situation is same. Why the situation is same? Can anybody tell me? See, Indian Council of Medical Research is saying this situation. And my own research last 3 years, it was like that. Now 21 people I have seen, all are the same. Why? If suppose the entire family is walking without chappal in a gravel area or a thorn area, what will happen? All of them will get injured, isn't it? Similarly, we are having certain habits. All of us are watching from morning. I came at 10:30. I see how people are eating, how they are conducting themselves. It's a sure recipe for bad health. We will look at that today. 80% population are insulin resistant. Insulin resistance is the root cause for lifestyle disorders. Why insulin resistance happens, we will talk about it. Look at, if insulin resistance is there, what all can happen? People can be having belly fat, people can have overweight, people can be having diabetes, pre-diabetes, blood pressure, PCOD, all root causes this. Friends, it's very interesting to know. I'm just giving some examples so that the point is sent through your remains in your mind. Say for example, you are going to US for 3 months, you are going to lock up your house and go. So what you do? You safeguard your house, you make sure that your cupboards are locked, suitcases are locked, bedroom is locked, main door is locked, with all the keys you go to US. You come back after 3 months. You come home and you open the suitcase, you pick up the key bunch, but you find the main door key is not there. All other keys are there. Is it? But all other keys are important. But most important is the main door key to enter the house. Similarly, the test what I am telling you about fasting insulin is something like it. Unfortunately, this test is not part of any packages. If at all it is in the package also, the range is too large. The range, when I say people say that my parameters are alright. See friends, here also, pass mark for any student, 10th student, what is the pass marks? Pass marks. How many? 40%. Let's say 40% is the pass mark. Anybody who has got 40% is pass, 41, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, 100. But tell me for your check, do you want 40% or you want optimal? What do you want? Most of us want our children to get at least the first rank or optimal mark. Similarly, friends, the parameters are designed like that. That's why people who are unhealthy also, they think they are pass. Let's look at it in more detail. Now, as you said, Balasar, when I met him in the park sometime in Jaljan, we were talking to him, he's 112 kg. I asked him, what are the problems you have? He said, no sir, I have PP and I have middle of migraine and some sleeping issues. So I'm taking two medicine. I said, I don't have any other problem, no sugar, no other problem, no cholesterol at all. I said, okay sir, let's get the blood test done. As I said to you, there are 7 blood test friends. I sent you 10 parameters. If all the 10 parameters, what are they? First of all, weight and waist size. Weight should be as per your height. Suppose somebody is 6 feet, the weight should not be beyond 75 kg. If a lady is 5 feet, in my opinion, 55 kg is not right. If you are carrying more weight, understand, you have in your bone, there is a crack. So if you are going to go with your bone with a crack, you are bound to get into trouble, if not today, tomorrow. So watch out. Next is waist size. Waist size should be half of 5 inches. If it is 5 feet, 60 inches, waist size should be 30. If it is somebody is having 35, that means there is a huge fat around their belly. Third one is blood pressure. The ideal blood pressure is 90 by 60 to 100 by 120 by 80. A lot of people say 120 by 80, but the best is 90 by 60. We should live a life without medicine. All of you agree with me on these 3 points or any other suggestions? Hello? Participation, please. I can't hear. So these are the 3 visual. At least 2 are visual. 2 are rather 1 only. Nobody can tell you whether it is on medication or blood pressure. So once we know these are the 3 cases. Now the other thing is that these are the important blood test friends. Fasting insulin. I'm sure 90% of these people who are here, they must have got blood test. This test has been not done. That means you don't have a main door key. Next is what? Fasting sugar HbA1c. These 3 tests will cost you 370 rupees. If anybody gets these tests, I can tell you what is going to be your problem next 10 years. Like Jyotish Go, I can tell you. You are in the wrong direction, and if you continue in the direction, you are bound to reach step by step. Belly fat, overweight, ladies, PCOD problem, blood pressure, all that will precede. Next is what? Thyroid profile and lipid profile. Next is what? D vitamin and B12. So how many parameters are there, friends? How many? 10. Out of 10, we must see how many we are. Let's look at our Mr. Bala, how many he had at that time. He was okay on 3 parameters. So, though it is not very scientific, Just to get an idea, I always believe a squint-eyed guy is better than a blind guy. Most of the time we are blind, let's be a squint-eyed at least to know. So out of 10 parameters, he has over 30%. So what are the problems he had? He was overweight, wastage is high, he had a fatty liver which I have not mapped here. He was pre-diabetic, he was not aware of it. See, pre-diabetic is a stage which you can know. Don't worry, I can send the PowerPoint presentation PDF to all of you and with the write-up, don't worry, just pay attention. If you are a pre-diabetic, too, I'm glad that he is at the age of 53, he became pre-diabetic. Friends, I became pre-diabetic at 35. I was full-blown diabetic maybe at 40. And I had blood pressure, I had kidney stone. All this thing happened because I have absolutely no knowledge on the body. As an engineer, I joined the company, I became service head, marketing head, and all that, general manager, marketing head, but zero knowledge on the body. So this is what I have done last 10 years, I have improved my knowledge, and what I learned for so many years, you can just learn in 1 hour. If you listen to this talk and you implement these things, I can guarantee in a week's time you see the comfort levels in your body. In a month's time, if you don't lose 2 kg, you can ask to come back to me. Provided you follow all the points what I am going to. This is the first step. As I said to you, in my boat, I am checking my boat. What is the condition of the boat? Can this boat take me to that 100 days? Tell me how many days your body will take me from now on. We don't know. 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, 10 years, we don't know. So friends, pay attention. Now again, this will not going to that. Now, this is not the case with only Baba. Look at the people. I have just mapped. These are the people in my group. Look at the age of what? 37-year-old, she's a doctor. Incidentally, I went to the doctor to talk and she became my follower. Look at her health score. All parameters are in red. She was telling me, sir, I'm not able to go to my second floor also in the hospital, I'm taking lift. It's almost 3 months now, she called me up and she has already improved her health substantially. Look at other people, all are 25 years and 39 years. The situation is extremely bad. If you see the key points, right? Key points. All of them are overweight. Okay, all of them, right? And some of them don't have blood pressure. And at least 4 of them are on medication. And some of them are having diabetes. All of them are diabetic and pre-diabetic. And this is how that score is there. Now what to do, friends? Why it happened? I just told you the simple example. The entire family is walking on the thorns. You are bound to have your food, isn't it? So let's see what are the mistakes we are making. What I am saying about 10 repeat wrong habits. That means we are doing day in and day out. Years, 10 years, 20 years. So fortunately, God has been so kind. Despite your so many repeat mistakes, we are all living and we are moving around. But are we moving around with the same energy and strength? No, we are not. So let's look at one by one. And all of you know that. Please let me know after listening to that how many mistakes you are continuing doing as of today. So once this session is over, I want you to be aware. This is the mistakes you are doing. Something as I told you, the boat. I am going in the boat for 100 days. If I take a screwdriver and hammer and keep on hitting at one corner, what will happen? I don't know whether I will reach the 100 days. So we are all doing that, friends. We are doing that. So be a good leader. Let's look at what happens. All of us know 7 hours sleep is important. It's not a rocket science. Isn't it? So, look at it. Are you able to sleep in the night, 10 p.m. to 5 a.m.? If not, pay attention. Make a note of it. That means, if you are not able to sleep 7 hours, say you are sleeping at 1 o'clock and waking up at 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, think that there is a crack in your boat. What is the next one? Chronic stress. I spoke about the stress. What stress will do to the people? Can anybody tell me what the stress does? How does stress affect us? What is the reason? What can happen to the stress? Stress can cause sleeplessness. Very good. What else? Do you know stress can cause diabetes?
Do you know stress can cause PCOD problem? Do you know stress can cause anxiety, stress can you get irritated? I always feel somebody is getting getting angry at people, the guy is stressed. I always, maybe the guy had wife problem. That's why he's stressed. Right? So stress can cause sleep disorder. When you are stressed, what is stress primarily? Why God has given the stress to us? If you look at the evolution, stressing because you fear death. Suppose you are in the jungle, there is a tiger, you have two options. Either to run away what you need energy, to run away fast, or to fight. You cannot fight tiger. So the body is designed, when you get stressed, you have a high glucose in your blood. High glucose in blood for long number of years, you are going to get all health problems. Not only that, when you are stressed, suppose somebody says, your main door is not okay, it's very not okay. Somebody says there's a tiger going around. You just tell the word and goes away. Will you be able to sleep? You are not able to lock the door and they know there is a tiger around. You can't sleep. What happens when you are stressed? You become more attentive. You have a great, more blood circulation in your forehead. When you get stressed, you are alert because there is a danger. Whether it is real danger or maybe your boss has scolded you, there is no danger. We get stressed. Same effect. Human body has not evolved. It only knows, oh my God, there's a danger. Either fight or fly or flight. But there is no fight with the boss. So they end up getting into trouble. So we also get stressed. Sedentary lifestyle. Sedentary lifestyle, so you don't know exercise. A lot of people tell me, no, sir, my college is 7:30, I have no time. Whether you are a president or a prince or a king, sedentary lifestyle will put you into trouble. Look at friends, in only humans. Humans can get the food, just walk into the kitchen, you get your food. If not in the food in the kitchen, you open the fridge, you get the food. No food in the fridge, call the Swiggy, you get the food. Look at the animal kingdom. For your information, an elephant walks for 50 kilometers for food in a day. Look at a street dog also. You don't find it is lying around, it's running, hunting for food. So human beings have got food available, so the sedentariness has come. Intoxicants like alcohol, tobacco, then stimulants, coffee, tea. Some of us, we all think coffee, there's no harm. One cup of coffee, I'm feeling great. So we don't consider coffee as some sort of problem. We'll discuss that. Processed foods. Once in a while, it's okay, processed foods, sugar, refined oil, fast foods, milk, bakery, cold drinks, ice cream. Friends, understand, what is processed food? Any food is made in a dabba, or a box, or a bottle, or in a tin. It's a process, it's not a food, it's a product. Biscuit is a product. Cold drink is a product. It's manufactured in the factory. What is the object of the product? Tell me. Why they make these products? So they want a long shelf life. If you make a food today, 2 days later it gets spoiled, whatever. So the shelf life is more, that's the reason they put lot of preservatives, lot of sugars to make it tasty, crisp, colorful. So they put all sorts of food less, more additives. So those things will hamper your hormones. So much. So okay, once in a while, no problem. But like a regular food keeping in the fridge, stocking at home and giving the chocolates every day to the child. Friends, understand, in the first place, we ourselves don't know about health. We are not clear. What sort of guidance we can give to the children? Same thing happened to me. Now my two grandchildren, fortunately my grandsons are, one boy is 8 years, another boy is 3 years. Since I became knowledgeable, touch wood there in US, they have not fallen sick. And I take them to the rains, nothing happens to them. Why? Because we are following certain guidelines. We are not damaging. I said abuses. How many abuses as of now people are doing? Raise hands and tell the numbers. Some of them we are knowing and unknowing. No harm. Can you tell me out of the 6, how many you are already doing every day? Answer? I used to do all 6. Hello? No answer? Earlier? How many we have? So we know, these are all, everybody knows. I'm not saying something rocket science, it's all available. Is it interesting or should I go fast? Hello? Is it interesting or should I go faster? Because I want people to
Yeah. Answer. Okay. Fine. So out of six, how many any of us has this abuses? See, understand, friends. One day, 2 days, no harm. But we are doing for decades. That's how the damage is happening. Okay. Now let's look at the seventh one: dehydration and the wrong way of drinking water. Dehydration. See, people don't drink sufficient water. How much water to drink? We don't know. And what is the right way of drinking water? We don't know. I had a kidney stone problem. I had to get admitted in the hospital twice in the midnight. Fortunately, no intervention. The doctor told me to drink more water. I started drinking more water. You have seen me, I only developed belly. Not the kidney stone, never came on. Because we don't know the process. We will understand this. Constipation, gas, bloating, poor gut health, no appetite, all these things. So what is constipation? Can anybody tell me what is constipation? A person who is unable to clear his bowels once in a day, if you are unable to clear your bowels, you are not able to go to the stool, we call it constipation. But let me give a different definition for constipation. I can tell you more than 80% of the population are constipated. 80%. How, when I give you the definition, you qualify yourself where you are. If a person is unable to clear his bowels once in a day, he is constipated. Everybody knows, right? I say, if a person is unable to clear his bowels immediately after waking up, within half an hour time, he is constipated. Maybe he is going to the toilet around 10 o'clock or after or evening, he is constipated. It's necessary that immediately after waking up, you are able to clear your bowels. Second, third, if a person is unable to clear bowels two times in a day, he is constipated. Third, fourth, if a person is unable to clear his bowels within the morning, maybe 1-2 hours time, two bowel movements, if he is unable to do, he is partially constipated. Friends, understand. The excretion which is available in our large intestine is not a goal to be kept inside. It must be exited at the earliest. Look at the animal kingdom. Animal kingdom, it happens. Look at a cow. Have you ever seen cow, you know, passing its stools? It just walks. Within 10 seconds, you see such a large quantity of excretion in the exits. A human being goes into the bathroom with a mobile phone or a paper. Maybe some other people, family members have to knock the door. That's the status. What is the distance between your navel to your anus? Just about 12 inches. And we are unable to clear the excretion in the 12 inches. So we will understand how do we go two bowel movements in the morning itself. Friends, if you are able to go two bowel movements in the morning, you get a feeling as you are not walking on the ground, you are not bound by the gravitation, you will be in a flying mode. You can only feel that experience once you have these things. Hydration and elimination, very, very important. This is the problem all of us having. Multiple times eating in a day. What is multiple times eating in a day? We are all, most of us are habituated to have a wet coffee, then breakfast, then in the office, by and large, everybody gets coffee or tea at 11 o'clock, and then the lunch, and then maybe 4 o'clock, some snacks, evening 6 o'clock, when you go early, maybe you have something to eat, 8, 9 o'clock, food. How many times we are eating? And lot of people think taking coffee is not a food. Remember one thing, friends, other than water, anything else you put in your mouth, once it goes, it requires digestion. So, in a day, from morning to night, how many times you are putting on? So, what happens? It doesn't happen for 1 day, 1 month, 2 months, for years. This is the greatest abuse everybody is doing. A lot of people tell, no, you eat less, you do that, follow the mark and other. It doesn't work. It works for a while. I've seen people who join gym and work out very hard, and the people with a lot of gritted teeth, they eat less, they eat special food, and once they lose about say 5-6 kg in about 2-3 months, they go back to the same thing. That's what Balasar was explaining. So many experiments he has done. Why are you eating multiple times? So I just tell you that eating disorders, we'll see that. Habitual eating, we all have breakfast time, lunch time, dinner time, and all that, all of us eating like that. Then what? That sense tempted eating. Suppose you are going on the road, somebody is making a jalebi. Oh my God, it's looking very tasty. Just go and pick up some 100 grams and eat. Just because you are going to sense tempted eating. Next is work culture. All of us having this habit, you see. Companies, all companies in the food cafeteria, coffee beans are come home to the corporate office and just stand in front of their gate. All people are walking with an extra tank in the front. Belly fat, overweight. All because of this number of times eating. Environmental eating compulsions. Principals are not once here. We went there. He offered us something to eat. We said, thank you, we don't want to eat. No, 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 you must take it. This is with our government affection. In India, what we feel is giving food. Adhine Deva Bhava is a culture. So we feel giving food, accepting is something good, but unfortunately it is causing problem to us, environment, compulsion. Then boredom eating, then casual eating, emotional eating, especially ladies, when they have periods time, they feel hungry. And then nutritional hunger, if you are eating more of crappy food, like ice cream, cold drinks and all, you'll feel hungry. Atithi Devo Bhava, all of us know this, you go to somebody's house, they will compel you to eat, isn't it? All of us experience this. Because if you look at this culture, this particular custom has come many years, many, many centuries ago. Because those days, from one village to other village, people have to go by pulakkad or by walk. They don't have anything on the way. So once they come to your house, you give them water and they give them food. That was all right. But nowadays, what is happening? I stay in third floor. I finish my meal and go to the second floor to meet my friend after half an hour, 1 hour. He is eating, he says, no, come, join, your sister made some special aid. I said, no, he will not leave us. Friends is very important, we should avoid this multiple times eating. The reasons are many. The point I am making to you is that it may not be the same, different things. End of the day, how many times you are eating. Understand, your current health is primarily dependent on what are the mistakes you've been doing so far? Prasadam. Somebody comes to you, just open his Tirupati Prasadam. What we do generally? Just to take a small piece, put it in the mouth. Isn't it? So this is a habit. So I tell people, even God himself comes and offers you Prasadam, accept it, thank him. Keep it with you. Eat along with your food. If you just follow this one principle, you have spent time. Yeah. Now let's see. Now what else? All this will cause overeating. See whether are we really eating when we are hungry? No. So next is, as I said to you, please note down this point. Other than water, coffee, tea is food. It increases your sugar and insulin. The problem is year after year we are increasing sugar. A lot of people I see them. I can tell you, friends, I have seen more than 500 blood reports. I can see the individual, ask their habits, and I can write down your biomarkers. Because, as I say, can anybody tell me, it's a whole family was working on thorns. Do you need any technology to tell you that they are the necks are all punctured? Not at all. Understand, belly fat, anybody has a belly fat, who is overweight? What is overweight? As I said to you, 5 feet person should be 55, a 6 feet person should not be beyond 75. Anybody is overweight, that means their biomarkers are not good. That means in your boat, you are already carrying one or two cracks. So watch out and pay attention. Friends, out of these 10 habits, what they can cause? They can cause toxins, nutrition deficiency, and insulin resistance, inflammation in the body, and then hormonal imbalance. And all this will lead to lifestyle disorders. What are the lifestyle disorders? The first and foremost is, can anybody tell me? Overweight, belly fat, blood pressure, thyroid problem, pre-diabetes, diabetes, cardiovascular diseases, all these are the reason for this. Tell me, friends, out of 10, I tell no, sir, 9, I am not doing any mistake. Only one mistake I am doing. Is it acceptable? Out of 10, 9 perfect, no problem. But only 9 I can't sleep, there's a problem. It doesn't work like that. So we are taking so far so easily. So work on that. Look at where are the areas you have a problem. Please work on that. So that's why I tell my group members, initial stage, I would like to handhold people. See, whenever you are learning a cycle, initial stage, if somebody doesn't help you, you are going to damage your knees. So understand this. Now let's look at what needs to be done. Now we have understood, number one, the 30 wellness secrets we talked about. First 10 is talking about your biomarkers. The second is what are the mistakes we are doing. Now we are going to learn what are the 10 daily habits which will bring your health. It can reduce your overweight, it can clear all your lifestyle disorders just by following 10. What are they? It seems to be very, tall claims, isn't it? But it is not, friends. I'll tell you one simple example for you. Suppose you are somebody from your house are throwing garbage in front of your house side. What happens after a few days, neighbors also will throw there because that's a garbage place. After a few days, what will happen? You start seeing mosquitoes, you start seeing flies, rats, dogs, pigs, and people going here and there also, they can use that as a public toilet. Now, let me tell you, what is the rat, cat and all, cockroaches and all, they are like diseases, belly fat, overweight, diabetes and all. Now you are saying, no, I want to reduce weight, sir. Just tell me, I want to reduce 5 kg weight. Lot of people ask me, what we need to do, we should remove the garbage first. Then what would happen? Like, Bala was saying, the weight loss is a side benefit. Weight loss, diabetic reversal, these are the side benefits. What is the main benefit? You are going to be healthy. You are going to be comfortable. You are going to be at ease. You are not going to fall sick. These are the benefits you are going to find. Let's see what are the things we need to do. Now friends, understand this. What are the things? 4 liters water you must consume every day. 4 liters. Now how do we do? We will look at it. 2 bowel movements. You must be able to excrete 2 times in a day. 1 hour walk is a compulsory, irrespective of your schedule. Stress management, self-control already. 7 hours night sleep is non-negotiable. Next is avoidance of processed foods and stimulants. Eat only twice when hungry and maintain the same timings. These are the fundamentals. Like you see, I have written on the top, I think you must have seen, there are 7 essentials for good health. All of you know to make coffee, what all you require? You require milk, you require coffee powder, and you require water and sugar, right? Similarly, for good health, these are the 7 essentials. What are the air, water, food and excretion, removal of the waste from the body? They fall part of the chemical part of it. That means what goes into your system, what gets out of your system. So that is chemical part. Next is what? Structural. What is structural? You have, how many joints you have? Anybody an idea? How many bones, how many muscles? We have 204 bones and we have 600 muscles. And we have 360 joints. Look at this, so much. That's why human being can be so flexible. I've seen one video, a gentleman of 5 feet 6 inches, he closed himself in a small suitcase. He bent himself and somebody closed him. Such wonderful body we have. But tell me, as of now, can we bend and hold our toes without bending the knees? Because we are not using all the joints. So let's look at what are the joints around you. Then he is called emotional. And then that is rest and mind management. Rest means what? All of us, rest means sleeping, correct? 7 hours sleep, right? Rest, giving rest your digestive system is very important. So let's see how we can do. I want to ask you one question. Is it interesting? Friends, if you understand this, it's going to transform your life in the next 3 months. Alright, so now we have understood what are the items required. See, I remember my mom used to make an amazing sambar, very delicious sambar. I don't know how to make sambar, but I went to one of my studies in Madhya Pradesh. One day I decided to make sambar. What I did was that I remember what all she's putting. I tried to make, I had some salt and some mirchi powder, some vegetables. I made some sambar. I could not consume it. It was the worst. Why? First of all, I did not know what are the ingredients required. I did not know what is the quantities to put. I also did not know the process. Then I called up my mom. I asked her, "Mom, what is to be done?" She explained to me, "Look, these are the items required." And she also said, "These are the quantities. Dal, you must take a glass, salt, a spoonful. You start the other way around."
So I did the process, which is very important. Just because I know what items, I know what is the quantity, I cannot turn out a good sambar. Correct? All of you agree? So now we know what are the requirements. 4 liters water, these are the, how to, what is the quantities we have seen. We also know what is the items required. How to make a good sambar, how to make a good hair. Now we are going to listen to that. Okay? Hello, you covered me. Look at it. Morning 5 a.m. to 10 a.m. It is called a fasting window. We should not take anything during that period. But all are habituated to have some coffee, tea and snacks and all that. So watch out. Let's look at this process and we understand. Now what needs to be done? Immediately after waking up in the morning, you must drink 1 liter water, focus your mind on your stomach, and with the intention of going to the toilet, you will be able to finish your first bowel movement. It's very easy, friends. But suppose you drink water and then you are talking to somebody or getting the TV and all that, you will not be able to pass your stools. Because there are 2 valves, one valve in the mind, another valve load on your stomach. So very important for this. So once you finish your first bowel movement only, you are licensed to get engaged in any activity. If I am a Chief Minister of Tamil Nadu, I tell people who themselves has not cleared their bowels, lock them in the bathroom. Let them not come out. We don't want them to go. Such an important aspect, right? Very, very important. All of us, mostly I feel ladies are that what is on this, because they have to get ready for their husband, children and all that. In the barque, they don't drink water, they don't finish their first bowel movement. So they get problems compared to gents. So watch out on this. So once you finish that first bowel movement, go for a 1 hour brisk walk, come back home, rest for 5-10 minutes, again drink 1 liter water, focus your mind on your stomach. You will be surprised to see how much of waste material is coming from your system. So 2 bowel movements in a span of 1 hour, 1.5 hour, 2 hours, and you have taken 2 1-liter, 1-liter, it will amazingly improve your hydration and elimination. That's what causes you, you know, the best of immunity and good health.
Great.
Alright, now once this is done, let's look at what needs to be done. Foods to avoid, all of you know the foods to avoid. Sugar, maida, salt, sweets, refined oil, processed foods, packaged food, junk food, milk, intoxicants, stimulants like coffee, tea, alcohol, ice cream and all that, you must stop. You say, what is this, sir? What is life for? If you want to enjoy, do enjoy, there is no problem. But the process is, you can. If you want to have ice cream, have it along with your food. You want to have a coffee tea, have it along with your this. You want to have a cool drink, no. If you want to have alcohol, have it with your food. That means, that's how it should be done. Next we will see water intake, how to take water, when and when not. See, water and food should not be at one time in your stomach. That means what, if you drink water, don't immediately seek for eating. If you eat food, don't drink water. So what is the process? By chance we go to somebody's house, they offer water. You drink water, then immediately don't go for eating food. Wait for half an hour, 20 minutes. If while eating, don't drink water, at least after 2 hours you need to drink water. Suppose you are getting stuck in the food and all, you can take 1 or 2 gulps, there is no problem. Is it clear? Have I made it clear to you, all of you? How to drink water, how much water to drink, when not to drink. Simple idea, if you remember this. Now the question of eating. This is a very million dollar question. See, most of this number of eating episodes, eating episode number of times eating. You know what is the mainstream advice? They say breakfast, lunch, dinner, you must all eat.
Any questions, ma'am?
Pay attention. See, all of us are said that breakfast, lunch, dinner is compulsory, everybody eats. And there is a suggestion by most of the dietitians, you can have 1 to 3 times some snacks. People tell you eat 5 to 6 times small meals at regular intervals. It's a disaster. It's a disaster. If you really look at it, friends, look at the human evolution, how it happened. Talking about thousands of years ago. Human beings are not having ready-made food. Any queries? Want to ask a question, ma'am? Don't worry, it's the ideal. We will work it out. See, the point is, I am talking about ideal.
People have got different schedules. We will discuss that. Absolutely no problem. We will, once you look at fully, see object, if you, you must have seen, madam, you have seen the ads are going, the big cube ads. Generally, as a child, what we used to do, we put some obstacle. What happens? Anybody observed? When ants are going, we put an obstacle. What happens? Does ants go back and sleep at their room? Or do they sit there quietly? They find an alternate way. They probably go over the obstacle and go side, and you, after half an hour, you see them, they're passing. Similarly, these are the far points. How do we do it? Based on our own schedule, we look at it. Right? So, number of times eating is one question people ask. How many times should I eat? Should I eat 6 times? Should I eat 3 times? Like that, one question always everybody has. Next is, what type of food we eat? Somebody says, don't take non-vegetarian, it is bad. Somebody says, you take only fruit. Somebody takes vegetables. Somebody takes keto diet. Somebody has diet, white diet, DASH diet, Farana diet, Dimaga diet, XZ. So many diets are there. Now the question is, which diet to follow? How many times to eat is the question. Third is quantity. Quantity means calories. What is the calories they recommend for male and female? Can anybody tell in a day? What is the mainstream advice? Any idea? So many calories one must consume, they say. Male so much, female so much. Any idea? Males, they say 2200 calories. Women, they say 2000 calories enough. So this 2200 calories, they say take it 6 times. This is the general thing. So this is a question. Whether I should eat 6 idli or 3 idli in the morning. Should I take 1 cup of rice or 2 cup of rice? That's the question always have. Type of food, number of times eating, quantity, timings. Lot of people have a very specific thing. You must have your breakfast before 8 o'clock. Somebody says you must have your dinner before sunset. Isn't it? So many times it is not possible. Like madam is asking, how is it possible up to 10 o'clock not be eating? So we will examine that. Now let me tell you friends, all these four are your choice. I am giving you the option. Okay, first option, I am also making some restrictions. So what type of time to eat, when to eat, what of the quantity is your choice. Now what I am saying, eat only when hungry and eat only twice in a day when hungry and maintain the same time. That is the only principle. It's so simple, but it appears initially it is difficult because we are all habituated eating 5 to 6 times. So let's examine this. 2 times eating. Now, friends, now what type of food to eat, it depends on what. Can anybody say, should I eat this type of food, that type of food, this quantity, that quantity? It depends on what. I would like to give a simple example for you to understand the logic behind it. Because I don't have any diet plan. I don't suggest any specific foods. It's yours. See, for example, 3 patients of 25 years, same built, 3 patients come to your ortho doctor, limping. They have some leg problem. They came limping with some help. And they all tell them, sir, yesterday night, it seems like we have slipped and my leg is paining. I am not able to keep my leg down. Okay. Now, what sort of, how the doctor will treat them, 3 of them. All of them seem to be same age and the same problem. And what type of treatment doctor will give? Any suggestions? Hello? 3 patients with the same problem. What sort of treatment? Madam, can you tell? You understood the question? Question you understood? 3 patients, the limping leg, they came to the doctor. Doctor, what type of treatment he will give? Anybody else? Just, not, anybody? Balasar, can you? Okay. Because it seems same age, same pain, seems to be, say, yesterday only night they have fallen. Now I have to give treatment. So, should it be the same treatment or different treatment, I am asking? Depends on what? Well, all are same weight, that's what I am saying. All are same weight. All are same age, that's what I said. Same age, all are looking like pigs or something.
Different height, sir.
Pardon?
Different height.
Different height? Let me put it. See, doctor will take X-ray. All A, B, C, 3 patients are there. A patient X-ray says there is no crack.
perfectly all right. He may have a little muscle problem. So I give him some boo or give him a tablet. I put a red bandage. All of you know the red bandage. Try to tell him that take rest 2-3 days, be careful. Second patient, when I see there's a hairline crack, I'll put him a plaster of Paris. I give him a stick. I tell him 6 weeks, don't put weight on your leg. Third patient, when I see he has a bigger crack, so I decide to do operation. I put him nut bolts and he's admitted for a week, and then I tell him to take rest for 6 months. It all depends on his condition. That's what I told all of you to check your health score. When I see your health score, you are overweight, your vitamin deficiency, your thyroid, your pre-diabetic and diabetic, your blood pressure, you are taking medicine, your belly fat, obviously it requires a little different, not too large. So that's how we should handle. Why, friends? Each individual is different. Everyone is unique. Suppose you eat 2 idlis, I eat 2 idlis. When we check our blood sugar, you will have different, I will have different. Correct? All of you agree? So it all depends on their health score, right? So now what do we eat? Well, they said to you, mild insulin resistance. Once you get that report, only we will know. Somebody don't have much of a problem, they can eat 2 times or 3 times in a day, no issues, they can eat whatever food they want. Somebody is having pre-diabetes or having other issues, they also can eat only 2 times, but you know, at least 1 time they should have a nutritious food or cooked food. We will examine that in the next slide. Somebody is diabetic. He's taking insulin, he's taking some medicine. Obviously, like as I said, you know, the person who had a crack required that bolt. Suppose I give the same treatment to all the three of them. All the three of them I do operation. Is it okay? The fellow who doesn't have any problem, I'm doing operation. And I'm saying, no problem, all of you go with that great bandage. What will happen to the guy who is injured? Friend, this is the biggest mistake all these dieticians, everybody is doing. Once you understand your health score, we will examine. It's not very complicated. It's very, very simple. Many times, simple things people don't adapt it. Unless I tell, very dramatically, people get it. Nothing in between 2 meals except water. That's what Bala sir and me did it when principal offered us something. Thank you very much. We did that. But I've seen many people, they were taking banana, they are taking this food, that food. So imagine how many times you are eating in a day. So you have abused with this particular defect for many, many years. I wish from today, will you all stop it? Can I hear? Hello? Yes. Have you all realized the importance of it? See, many times we don't realize that, what is there? He just give me a stutter. He has only given me a small, he was actually some, what is that? Coffee, XYZ. Other than water, anything you put in your mouth is food. Friends, all of you know you have all mixies at home. In a mixie, whether you put a 1 spoonful of masala to grind or you put full masala, you have to put it all or not. And then afterwards you have to clean or not. Right? Maybe when you put a 1 spoonful, maybe you have to grind it for maybe a minute, maybe half a minute. If you put full jar, maybe do it for 3 minutes. Similarly, friends, every time you put food in your mouth, there is a spike of sugar, there is a spike of insulin, and then over a period of time, there is a roller coaster, sugar up, insulin, sugar up, insulin, sugar up, insulin. Years. I always curse God. God has given us too long a rope. So we think nothing happened to me, true, nothing is happening to you. But the damage is taking place. Right, friends? As I said to you, other than what is food? Is coffee food or not?
Food.
Please speak out. Is coffee food or not?
Food.
Food.
Tea, what about tea?
Food.
What about coconut water?
Food.
What about a small biscuit?
Food.
Small prasadam, Tirupati prasadam they offered to you. What is it?
Food.
So, today I have offered prasadam. Another day somebody comes with a birthday cake, another day somebody offers, end of the day, we are continuously taking. Right, friends? Now, balance water, we have already taken 2 liters water, 1 liter in the first early getting up, after 1 hour of this walk, you take balance 2 liters, how to take? Drink balance 1 to 2 liters water in installments between 2 meals. Suppose you had first meal at 11 o'clock, what time you should start drinking water? 1 o'clock, 11 o'clock, 2 hours. So 1 o'clock. So 1 o'clock you take a glass of water. Only in the morning you are taking 1 liter at one time. Other time you are taking installments. Take a glass of water. Remember, drink one hour like that. Always keep water in a bottle so that you can keep a track of how much water you are drinking. Many times we just go pick up a glass and we say, everyone, I drink a lot of water. Friends, at one time, until my age 54, 2014, probably I have been drinking 1 liter. And I ended up with kidney stone problem. And not only that, various other health issues because of poor hydration. So will you all drink 3 to 4 liters from tomorrow? You all understand how to drink water? Now you all understand how to go about eating and all that? So what type of food is your choice? I am not telling you restrictive food. There is no diet plan. There is no restriction on quantity. You can enjoy. And I have seen in my group, people are eating at 9 a.m. in the morning and at 5 p.m. And somebody is eating at 1 p.m. and evening 9 p.m. And somebody is eating around 11 o'clock, I take at 11 o'clock and my second meal at 7 p.m. Absolutely no problem. What type of food do you want to eat? Remember, as I sent you 3 patients for a story. If you are diabetic, you have other health issues, you have to be very, very vigilant. A student who gets 20% marks, a student who gets 80% marks, they require different treatment, isn't it? 20% वाला को थोड़ा मार मार के पढ़ाना पड़ता है. Must make him study more laborious. Alright. Next is what? Rest to digestive system. How do we give rest to digestive system? Fasting. But if I tell you to fast, we cannot fast. So at least 14 hours, 12 to 14 hours overnight fasting. Suppose you had your dinner at 9 p.m. So next day, at least 11 o'clock, don't touch anything. Suppose you had your dinner at 7 p.m. So next day at least 7, 8 o'clock, 9 o'clock, don't have anything. That 12 hours, 14 hours. This is the buzzword actually, intermittent fasting. I don't like this word, buzzword, intermittent fasting. You eat 2 times, choose your timings, choose your food, don't take anything in between, automatically you'll fall in place. Okay? And stress management, Sara has already covered, I'm not going to that. What are the, we have daily challenges and we have major life incidents, something happened to our life, some relative had passed away or some accident. So those issues cause health problems, stress, health issues, overweight, health problems, those are all cause stress. How to go about stress management, you can do. Friends, very important is let go attitude. Sometimes we hold on, why this guy sent me this? So learn these things. Isha Inner Engineering is an amazing program. If you have done it, Sadhguru Jiggy Vasudev, it's a 2000 rupees program for Tamil people. You can do that session. Amazing session. You will substantially benefit. And Sara has already given great ideas about stress management. Follow that. Next is what? 7 hours night sleep is non-negotiable. Right? Now, look at, I have on the right side, I have written compliance. You please keep this chart in your fridge. Every day you see previously how many you have done. Oh my God, yesterday I did not do the exercise. I did not go to bowel movements. That means out of 10 you have done only 8. I want all of you to do 10 out of 10 next 1 week. And I can tell you in 1 week you can see the difference in terms of your comfort level. Now what will happen by doing this 10? It will improve your gut health. It will improve your insulin sensitivity. It will improve D and B12. See friends, what food to eat? Just eat what are homemade food. Preferably avoid white rice. You can have brown rice or millets, or you can have multigrain chapati. You eat whatever sabjis. You don't buy this refined oil. You can make pressed oil, chikki oil they call. You can have ghee. You can enjoy your food. If somebody is having some problem, one time uncooked food is like this. You can have sprouts, you can have fruits, you can have coconut dates. This one time you can have, because cooked food is not having any nutrition. If you take uncooked food, it will be nutritious. If anybody is diabetic, what they should eat? No carb food. Where is Senthil sir? Is carb or carb? Senthil sir. So no carb food. He followed no carb food. In a month, miraculously, he has improved his HbA1c. Now, this will improve your insulin sensitivity, friends.
This is again, look at Bala sir, how he has improved. He has lost 20 kg weight, 10 inches waistline reduction. He was pre-diabetes, he became non-diabetic. His health score improved from 20% to almost 70%. This is possible. Is it, whatever I said is very, very easy. Only thing is you have to have a focus. And there are other people who have improved. Look at 40%, 80% jump. 40% to 70, 80% jump. That people with diabetes, they got regarded as a problem. And another person, 30% to 70%. So this is what I wanted to share with friends. Anyway, look at, these are some of the fundamentals. See, the illiterates of 21st century are not the ones who can't read and write. The illiterates of the 21st century are the ones who cannot learn, who cannot unlearn, who cannot relearn. It's very important. Friends, in my life, I always on the lookout for unlearning and relearning. So I keep on changing these flights, making it more appropriate to talk. Thank you very much for listening. My name is Gangeshwar Rao. I am not a doctor. I am not a dietitian. I am not a yoga master. I have only done something on my own research. And last 10 years, I am helping people free of cost. I am passionate. I want all of you to improve your health. And I want all of you to become a coach. Whatever I learned, you can teach people. You can improve health in your own family and your friends. Thank you very much for listening. Any doubts you can ask me. Thank you. There was a World Health Day. So when you get drenched in the rain, why we are afraid to get drenched in the rain, friends? Because we feel we get cold, we get cough. I used to get cold and cough until 2014. When I go for a swimming for one day, I used to sneeze for 3 days. Last 10 years, if it rains, I am in the rain. Nothing happens to me. It is possible for all of you, friends. I hope you enjoy the rain and all the health. Thank you very much once again.
Thank you.